Good evening. Good evening, my students. Good evening, everybody. Today is Monday, 16th day of November 2020. I want to do another video analysis today because of what's happened. There was a disruption. News made some news, caused some strange movement today, but I'm not perturbed. I don't trade the news, but I know that news sometimes disturb the movement of the market. Yes, news can affect the market momentarily, but it doesn't change the trend. All right, let me go ahead. This is Euro USD. You can see I'm expecting the market to continue to go up. But sometimes in the day, I thought we were gonna have another drop. When the news came out, it dropped a little, and you can see it is still going up. Two things we are expecting. One is the previous move ended here, and this is wave one of a new cycle, and here will be wave two. This is one. If here is wave two, then we're gonna have the sale might continue below here and keep going. Second, we might see break this area and touch here, or break it to commit to the wave five or wave C. Remember, in the past videos, I said that we are expecting a truncate of the fifth wave. It may still happen. A truncate is when wave five closes below wave three. That's the truncate. That is, if we have a break of this place and it couldn't touch here and continue going down, then we will have the sell. So right now, I'm not in the market, but I will only consider sell if the price breaks this area. If it breaks this area, I will not buy because it is very short. It might turn down from here. It is not a good trade unless you are a scalper. Okay, that's for Euro USD. On pounds USD, you can see the news could not change the market. We are still looking for downwards. Wave one, wave two. And if you check last video, I expect that we might have A, B, C as wave two. But let's see if it will happen. The sell might continue from here and keep going down. It might still come here, go here, and begin to sell. In essence, what I'm saying is that pounds dollar is a sell market, though it can still buy momentarily, but I'm not going to buy it. That's for pounds dollar. Pounds yen, you see, because of the news, of course, this blue box was here yesterday, and I said that the market might come to blue box and turn. Though it happened, I expected it to happen in a corrective manner, but the news made it to touch here, but it couldn't go above here. So if you are not on the market, I advise you to sell if it breaks here. I'm in the market already. I didn't close because my stop loss is above the blue box. So it couldn't touch my stop loss. So I'm in the market already. So if you're not in the market, if it breaks here, you sell. That's the right thing to do. Euro pounds, you know, Euro pounds have a strange move I can't understand, because they use it used to go the same direction with pounds yen, but Euro yen seems to do something different. But we will see it in future. So because of this sharp drop, you know, my focus was, if this line is broken, then we're gonna buy and watch what happens here. But because of this sharp drop, I expect a further move down, maybe towards 50% Fibo or 61.8 Fibo before we have another buy. Now, the buy can end here and go down. It can come up here and go down. Thirdly, this is the most unlikely. A break of this trend is the most unlikely, at least for recent time. So I expect it to drop, go either turn from here or turn from here. So I don't expect a buy that will go beyond 125 for now, but I expect a buy. Okay, on the 1 hour, you can see it on the 1 hour. This is a very nice channel yet to be broken. So because of this rejection, I expect a drop towards here or here, then a buy or a buy, and it comes down. Keep watching. Gold. Yeah, I entered gold when gold dropped, but because of the news, it came up again. But I'm in a loss, but little money. My stop loss is here. I think it's not gonna kill it. Even if it kill it, I watch what happens here. I strongly believe that gold will still drop. Gold is going below 1800, but it may kill my stop loss. I don't care. If it kill it, I don't care. Last time I entered here last time and closed here. So if I lose this time, it won't pay me much, because I took a bad trade, but that was a disruption from the news. So this happened. My trade started here. No, my trade started here. So I'm losing little money for now. So, but I'm still believe it will go down. If you are not in the cell, don't enter now. Wait for the break of this place so that it is safe to trade when here is broken. Okay, that's 4 hours for gold. 1 hour on gold is the same thing. From the 1 hour, you can see this is a yesterday top. With all the news disruption, it couldn't close above yesterday high. So what does it indicate? It indicates that we are still in the sell. So you can either sell from here, but the best thing to do is to wait for the close above here, then you sell towards 1800 and the below. So gold and silver is almost the same movement. So I'm expecting, I'm not in silver cell anyway. I'm not selling silver, but I will consider selling if price breaks this low, or if I see a sell setup on 1 hour. I always mention sell setup. Yes, if you want to learn, you can join the class. I'm saying right now, I charge a little money. Next year, I will hike the amount. I know the normal amount, I know the good amount to charge for the knowledge I give you, but this year, I'm doing something special. Okay? So, expect a sell. You can enter a sell at the break of here. Or if you know about sell setup, watch 1 hour. If you see sell setup, you sell from here. But if you don't know about sell setup, wait for the break of this area. Okay, that's for silver. Silver 1 hour. Okay, because of these three candles, we might have a delay before we sell. Nevertheless, I'm not going to buy silver. I will sell silver. If I see sell setup anywhere from here, I will sell. If I don't see sell setup, I wait for the break of this low before I sell. Okay, And you remember yesterday I said if we see a drop, we sell. Though I didn't see the drop on time, I only sell because when I saw it, I said to sell only gold. So if you enter the sell after the drop, you will be on loss. But remember I said that that stop loss will be above the blue box. So it's still good as long as this 25.06 is not taken. It's still a sell, and the target is 22.6, 22.7 area for silver. USD card, nothing has changed. I entered the market at this area because I see the previous big time ended here. So I entered the sell here, sorry, the buy here. So when this was happened, my market was on break even. So it's just about 10 pips to close on break even. It didn't close, it's reversed and going up now. So I expect nothing but up for USD card. Though it may go down, but all I see is up move. That's what I see. AUD USD, yeah, you know, I still maintain that AUD USD will drop. So as long as this area is consigned, this is similar with one. This is A, B, C. So it can still come down from here, but if it closes above here, I forget about the selling. I've heard about the sell. So for now, don't jump in and sell unless you see a sell setup on 1 hour. If not, wait for the break of this low. If you want to learn more, you join my class. I teach you all the things I used to say about setup. Okay, on 1 hour. 1 hour is easier. If this channel is broken, then you can sell. But if you are not in the market when the channel is broken, maybe the price is here. It's better you wait for the break up here, because reason is it can break, come down here and begin to do something like this, but then you become frustrated. But if you wait to break here, then you can sell. But if you sell from here, you can move your market at the break even before it begins to correct, if it will do that. But all I can see is a sell setup. If it breaks all these places and begin to go high, I'm not to buy. I know my reason. I will not buy if it breaks here. I'm not to buy. I know my reason. So I still expect a drop before the buying continues. Although overall trend is buy. Don't get me wrong, if you check my previous videos where I analyze the daily candle, you see that the main movement is up, the main trend is up, but it's gonna correct down here. Okay, US 500, S&P 500. Remember on my previous videos I see that this is A, B, and we're looking for C. So but I expected the B to end somewhere here, but the B anyway is still the same thing. I'm expecting a drop, but the drop might end here, it might come down here, but I'm expecting A, B, C. We are gotten B, remaining C. So what I'm saying is, if you want to sell the C, if you get the sell setup, use small lot size. Reason is that the main trend is up. Whenever I'm trading against the trend, then I use smaller size so that if it goes against me, I lose more. But if I'm trending in line with the trend, I use my normal lot size. This S&P 500, Euro NZD. I touched this market, I think, 2 weeks ago. But remember, I told you that the previous connection has entered here. If you go to previous videos, you watch where I analyze daily candle, daily time frame. It ended here. So this is wave one. Wave two might still come into this blue box, but this is from here to here to here is 61.8 Fibo retracement. So you will not get another drop, but I will if I see buy setup before the break up here, I will buy. If I don't see buy setup, once it breaks here, I will buy for now. But if it closes below this line, this wire line, then I will wait. Maybe it might still touch 88.8 Fibo, but I believe that it has ended. For now, I'm looking for buy setup. Eurgbp, remember this. I said that this correction is over, and since then it's going up. It's going up. I said that we will likely have something like this. As you can see, it's still going up. So if you are in the buy, move your if you entered here, where I entered, then move your stop loss to break even somewhere here. If not, wait for either the break of here or break of here, then you buy. I don't see any sell setup on pounds, euro now, on euro pounds or whatever. Usdjpy. Okay, this is one of the page that news disrupted. I entered the buy somewhere here. It came up and dropped. It killed my stop loss, so I lost this trade. So my stop loss was here. But sorry, I mean it didn't kill my stop loss, but if it drops further, it will kill my stop loss. My trade is still intact, but I don't want to close it because this is secondly. My main focus is that here we have gotten the reversal. This candle is a pimba, is a good reversal candle. So this correction, I assume it has ended here. So, but if it drops further, it will kill my stop loss. Then I will take the loss and I watch for buy setup. You know, you don't gain every market. You gain some, you lose some. But you don't go, you don't deliberately lose. And when you lose, you take it with the good faith. So my stop loss is just below here. If it comes down further, it will kill my stop loss. But no problem, if it kills it, I watch for buy setup around here. I'm gonna cover it. Okay. Dow Jones Industrial Average. Yeah, you can see I'm expecting a drop. You know, the market goes by structure. The last structure is that the market will drop, but it may not drop. But what I'm saying that I would like to buy, but I cannot buy it here. If I don't see a drop, a pullback or a correction, I will not buy unless I see a proper buy setup. But for now, I'm waiting for a drop. If it happens, I join the buyers. If it doesn't happen, I may leave it for now. It's not good to enter markets like this because anything can happen. Okay, now ask yourself, if when this was happening and you enter the buy here, what would have been your fate? You will lose. So, but if you waited, maybe and entered the buy here, you might still be in the market because it will give some room for stop loss. So, if I get a drop here, I will buy. But for now, nothing to do on it. Okay, and that is the last chart we are going to talk about. I don't want to talk about Bitcoin. I said it yesterday, it's still going up. If you like our forecast and if you want to learn how we do what we do, join our Telegram channel, subscribe to our YouTube channel, share our video. If you join our Telegram channel, if you want to learn, we teach you almost free of charge this year. We teach you almost free of charge this year. We just pay a little money. By next year, everything will change. So for now, you have the chance to learn how we do what we do. If you be following us, you will see that our results have been tremendous. So I think we are doing it. We are doing something good. Take your time and learn, and stop guessing. Trade with proper money management. Use stop loss. Don't ever trade. Let your loss size be in harmony with your equity. That's all for tonight. Thank you and God bless you. Good night.